Welcome back to WebSense Pro. My name is Bilal Nasir and I'll be teaching you guys how to add swatches on Shopify product page today. So you'll be adding a small piece of code in order to add Shopify swatches on your product page. So let's jump into it. So guys, after learning from this tutorial, you'll be able to make your product page look like this, where you'll have color swatches and color will be changing when you will click on these color swatches. So let's jump into the code and let me show you how you guys can do it. So guys, this is our Shopify dashboard and the first step is to add the product with variations. So I'm going to add the t-shirt product. T-shirt. Let's price it $10 and add in the main media file from here. And now I'll select the needed option where it will show the variations. So from options, check mark, this product has options like size or color. Click here and then add in color and then values of the color. In our case, we'll have black, white and red. So we added the main image as a red one. So I'll make it the first one. Now click on done and hit save. And now our product has been added. Now switch it to active product. Click on save again. And now we'll go to our settings page to add in the meta field. Click on settings. Scroll down to meta fields. Click here. And then click on variants. And from variants, add a definition by clicking add definition. Name it color. And in namespace, add in color dot values. Now from select content type, select on color and hit save. Now go back to our product page again. So this is our product page. Click on that. And from each variant, click on edit. Now in this red color variant, I'll select a picture, which is red color. Click on done. Scroll down to meta fields where we'll select the color red. And there we go. Now hit on save. Now repeat the process with a black color variant. Select in the image first. So I'm going to upload the black color image now. Select the image, hit done, and now scroll down to the bottom where it says meta fields, and in color, select the black color, hit on save, and I'll repeat the process with white color. Again, add in the image for white color. Click on done, scroll down to the bottom, and from meta fields, add in the white color. Hit save. Now final step is to edit the code of our liquid file to display the color swatches. So at the moment, our product page looks like this. So that's how it looks like. By editing the code, we'll be able to see swatches which will replace these buttons. Now let's go to the online store. And click on Actions and Added Code. Before editing the code, make sure to duplicate the theme. So if you're working on a live theme, you don't want to be mess up your theme, right? So take the backup of it before editing the code. Okay, now click on edit code and search for main-product liquid file. And here's the file. And now in this file, we will search for this code and we will replace this code with this code. Okay, now let's search this code. So this is the blog post and link of this blog post you'll find in the video description. Okay, now copy this and find this code in our main-product liquid file. Actually, let's search in the first line because due to the line break, it's not showing up properly. Copy the first line and search it on our main-product liquid file. Okay, so that's the code. And these are the three lines which we'll be replacing with this code. Okay, now copy this code and replace it with this code. Normally, you will find this code in line number 202, 203, 204, but I just displayed the code which you will be looking to replace in, so you don't make any mistakes on that. Okay, now after that, click on save. And now let's go back to our product page and see if our color swatches are showing up fine. So that's our product page. And let's preview our product page. And here we go. Our color swatches are showing up fine. So click on them and they are functioning properly. So if you have multiple color, you can, if you have more than three colors, you can add more color swatches. So I hope you guys like the tutorial. Make sure to subscribe to the channel, comment on the video below, and share it with your fans. Have a great day.